lot of my students that I had were a bunch of joking brats. Like, everyone had all these attitudes, but, like, fun attitudes, not anything, like, where you're, like, mad about it and you're just, like, constantly rolling your eyes at them. I feel like every student I had who's graduating this year was that kind of student. Or, like, I'm just like, oh, okay, this is happening? Sounds great. You know what I mean?
After coming back from distance learning, I've seen a lot more kids being excited coming back. They want to come to school, wanting to be back with their friends. So that was great. They had more energy, more passion to be back. I think that's one thing that stood out, is that it's not like, you know, every year, like, oh, man, I got to back to school. Now it's like, oh, I get to see my friends. I get to celebrate with them my last year of school.
Just a lot of growth that they had, a lot of maturity. A lot of these seniors I have, when they were sophomores and juniors and whatnot, but just seeing a lot of their growth throughout these years and just battling through adversity, through a pandemic and stuff like that, it just, they opened my eyes. It's just like anything is possible as long as you set your mind to it. So I'm proud of this class and ready to see what they're ready to do next. Wish I could turn you back into a stranger.
Really, really stoked to go to college. I had gone to private school, so I was ready to like be around people again and meet new people. And I don't know, when you graduate, you're just like super excited because everything is like coming up, like your whole life is ahead of you, and you just have all these possibilities, and you don't know like which way it's gonna go. And I just remember being really excited about that unknown for some reason.
I really reminisce just about all the fun times that I had. And luckily I get to keep seeing that happen over and over and over again as the activities director. Those were really the best times, to have all that fun with my friends and go to dances and sporting events and play, you know, powder puff football and all of those kinds of things that are still part of our traditions at Bloomington High School now.
When I was your age, thinking back to something positive, I think just living in the moment, really taking the opportunities to be with your friends or those that you thought were your friends and just really be carefree at the moment. I mean, you guys are gonna learn really soon that you don't have that in the future. And I think just really enjoying my high school days.
When I was your age, not too long ago, I do remember my college years a lot. It was a lot of fun. I remember study groups, but it was not so much for the study, but for the fun. You know, the going out for tacos, the coffee in the middle of the night. It was a lot of fun, yes. And a lot of cute guys on campus.
One thing that I'm proud of learning at that age was never to procrastinate things. Like, it has been my approach to finish whatever was given, whatever was assigned, and then enjoy free time. I wish somebody would have told me, babe, someday these will be the good old days. All the love you forget, and all these reckless nights you regret. Someday soon your whole life's gonna change. You'll miss the magic of these good old days.
I was thinking about the. I wish I would have. Done more fun things in college. Like, I really enjoyed college and I had fun and stuff, but I wish I would have traveled more. I wish I would have like maybe studied abroad. I wish I would have, I don't know. I wish I traveled more when I was younger and had the energy for it. So if I were you, I would go and travel like as often as you could, even if it's just to like small places nearby. Traveling doesn't have to be like, oh, I'm going to, you know, Greece or whatever. It could just be like, oh, I'm gonna go to San Francisco next weekend or Santa Barbara or whatever. Just like getting out of the area that you're in and like going somewhere and doing something different and just being somewhere else. I think that you should do that like as much as possible as you can when you're younger, because when you get older, it's a lot more difficult to maneuver that into your schedule.
I don't know if I have any regrets, to be honest. I really try not to have any regrets, because then I just dwell on them, you know, and then don't move forward. So honestly, I would say I don't regret too much. For a minute, I did regret not going straight to university because I have a lot of friends who started their careers early, and I started my career late. So that was one regret for a while, not doing that. But actually, when I realized that it was the best thing I did, I tried not to think about that. So
I regret maybe not applying myself more. You know, I was successful. I finished medical school. I did good. But I even had a teacher coming, calling me into his office, and he goes, "You know, Marcia, you could be in the top five, but you like your friends too much." And I'm like, "Oh, okay." So it was a compliment. He thought, you know, "I'm not mad at you. I think you're smart, but I think you need to focus more." And I'm like, "Oh," but you know, it was a big change. You know, college, like young to college, it was a big change, and I want you to be aware of that. You know, it's a rude awakening sometimes.
Actually, I would say I didn't get the opportunities that I see around these days. I do regret not being involved in extracurricular activities so much due to lack of availability of those things.
So you guys are an impressive group of students, and I am so proud to have interacted with all of you at some time. I wish you nothing but success and happiness, and to my Pathway kids that I've had since freshman year, I am so very proud of you, and I thank you for letting me be part of this journey of yours. And again, congratulations, class of 2022.
My message for my kids now is, for the class of 2022, will be think big. Think big. You're only going to be as big as your thoughts. And if you think little, you're going to stay stuck there. So think big, shoot for the stars, and you may land a little lower, but it's good to shoot high. Okay? I'm still trying to date a rock. So, hey, you got to shoot.
You guys have had to go through a lot in the last couple of years. This pandemic was no joke. Being at home in the middle of, like, your high school, like, life is terrible, you know? So you've lived through a lot of things, and you're here. You persevered, and you did really great, and you worked really hard to get to this point. So just don't lose that part of you. Like, life is going to throw all kinds of stuff your way, like all kinds of things. You're not going to be prepared for a lot of it, just like we weren't prepared 2 years ago when everything shut down in the middle of the year. So I mean, just kind of remember this, and remember like this feeling of how, like, of what you've accomplished and what it took to get here. And I just want you to remember that, so that when it's hard, you can remember that that's what you're going to feel at the end, like once you've made it through. Do you know what I mean? So don't give up. Just keep going. You did it before. You can do it again. It'll always pay off. It'll be great. We're really proud of you. Good job. You know what I mean?
Classes. Don't be afraid to fail. You know, I share with my students all the time that I've failed so much, and actually I learned from my failures. I learned how not to approach certain things or what to do, but it's okay also to fail, and it's okay to hear no. One thing I share with my students is that it took me 32 interviews before I got the job to become a teacher, and I didn't give up. So don't give up. Don't be afraid to fail. You keep pushing to whatever it is that your heart is telling you to go, your passions. That's what I did, you know, and surround yourself with people who are there that encourage you, who are there to celebrate you, because that's what I had to do. I had people who doubted me. People said I would never be successful. People tell me that I wasn't going to get into my dream schools. And I had to surround myself with people who actually believed that with me. And then I was able to do that and be successful. So don't be afraid to fail. Surround yourself with people who are there to celebrate you. And don't give up.
My final message is, first of all, I wish you all success. Okay. And I wish that you would stick to this level of motivation all your life for anything that you want to accomplish. Right now I see a lot of motivation in you to accomplish everything that is assigned to you. And that is one thing I want you to continue doing that. Don't lose your zest for excelling and trying to be the best. You are doing it right now, and I hope you will continue doing that throughout.
All right, shout out to all my seniors in class of 2022. You guys did it. If you guys could go to school through a pandemic, do all the little things you guys are able to do, you guys can do anything. Shout out to my baseball boys. I'm proud of you guys. You guys have matured so much from then until now. Shout out to all my students. You guys have grown so much, not only matured wise, but you guys have actually gotten a lot taller. My advice to you guys, don't be afraid to take chances. Find what drives you, find what motivates you. For me personally, what motivated me was my family, my future family as well. Find what, and hold that close and dear, because there might be days where you don't want to do it, but sometimes you just got to find a way to learn to love it. Find what motivates you. And also one more thing, don't forget your roots. Don't forget about Bloomington. This is what laid your foundation. So remember Bloomington and go out and get it. That's all I got to say.
Class of 22, congratulations. You've made it. You've done it. All the hard work, the pain. Now it's time to celebrate. Enjoy it. Make good decisions and make sure you guys follow your heart. Do whatever's going to make you happy in life. Don't think about anybody else. Think about what is your passion. Find your passion and pursue it. Because ultimately, you're the only one that has the answer to yourself for the rest of your life. So congratulations, guys. You did it. Keep it up.
Well, it looks like it's so long for now. Please come back to visit us. We want to hear about you. I know y'all don't like Facebook, but find me on Facebook because I'm an old person. And that's where I get to find joy in seeing what you're up to. It's one of my favorite things to see all of, you know, my former students and what they're doing and keep up with all of the stuff. So please do that. Get old like me and join Facebook and find me on there so that we can stay connected. One of the biggest things about Bloomington High School that I love is that I do feel very connected to this place. Go Bruins, go 1991, go Class of 2022.